I'm just going to do a real simple Albert King style riff today. And the previous riffs that I looked at have been ones like... And... this time I'm going to take a look at a riff that Stevie used a lot, and it involves a technique that Albert King used, which was starting a bend here, but then dropping a half step and bending partway up, and then going back up here. So the riff, all in all, is like this. Alright. So all we're going to do is I'm playing in the key of G-flat, which is what Texas Flood was played in. So I'm going to slide up here. This is the main box. So I'm going to slide up into this box. All right, this is the same box that I used in, I believe it was Lesson 2 and Lesson 4. And the riff just simply goes like this. Start by two hits on the root note and immediately up to this bend, and we start letting the riff come back down, almost like a baseball that's hit into the air starts to come back down after it reaches its peak. But before it gets back down, we catch it a half a step down with this finger and we bend it back up. And we can't quite reach the point where this one was, obviously, because we're half a step lower. And then as soon as this guy's getting close, the ring finger comes in and helps out. So I'm going to play it real slow one more time. Let me start on the right note this time. And then you can follow up with the transition riff that I taught a while back. So what you'd end up with is... a couple things here. You can pluck the strings on the high bends with your finger here. Instead of picking it, you can use your finger to pluck the strings. And if you do that, you get that real kind of screaming tone that Albert King used to get, and something that Stevie certainly got from him. First two notes, you can put a little vibrato on it to give it a little flavor. But that's pretty much it. Just another riff to have in your arsenal.